Welcome to Date with Danu. Thank you for joining us on the show. Today's a very special show. It's a show about family, it's a show about achievements, and it's a show about beautiful people. As my first set of guests on the show, I have a mother-daughter combo, and I really wanted this combo to come some time ago, but there were some speed bumps, unfortunately. But it's all about peddling through it all and achieving the final end result. And they have been doing a great job at it. I got to know about this Iron Lady's life story, and it inspired me so much. And I wanted to share her story. And I'm happy to have Professor Ramani Arasakuraratna and the daughter, Dr. Shanika.
Hi, I'm Ramani Arasakuraratna. I'm a cosmetologist and an aesthetician.
Hi, I'm Dr. Shanika, and you know me as the beauty doctor.
I'm excited to be a part of Date with Danu.
I think Date with Danu gets us to see the fun side and the naughty side and the exciting side of people's lives. I'm excited to be a part of it today.
Danu, I think Danu is a third child for me.
Well, something about Danu. I think he gets the glam diva out of me all the time, so.
Welcome to the show. You're looking gorgeous as always.
Thank you very much.
So I'm going to start with, I have to call you auntie. Is that okay? It's so, like, I find it so strange when I have to, like, shift to this mode and be like, so Miss Ramani. So let's stick to that. So tell me, you have an amazing story about you, but I don't know about it, and I think a lot of people in my generation might have not had the privilege of hearing it, and I really wanted to be on this show with you to speak about this story. It's very inspirational. And yeah, also the fact, of course, Shani has been here, so she's the new one in town, so I'm going to start with her. So let's start off. How are you doing today?
I'm doing well today, and there is a nice story behind it.
Yeah.
Right? You wanted to know about it.
Yes, I do want to know about it, because this journey, as our title sponsors as well, Crystal Skin Clinic, now stands as one of the best places for everyone to rush to when they feel like their confidence has been really burned to the ground. But when you started this journey as a girl or as a lady who wanted to just work, keep herself busy, did you ever think it'll stand this tall today?
No, never.
It was just a step by step.
Yes. So, as I told you, it's a very beautiful story according to my knowledge. And soon after doing my A-levels, I decided to go and work. And with my father's help, I was able to join this well-known, it was a Japanese company. So I joined that as an accounts assistant, because I was an accounts genius in school.
But you got Colombo Uni and you didn't go.
I didn't go because of my brother. He didn't want me to join.
Protecting the sister.
But my brother suggested me, why don't you join this good opportunity that you have got. So I decided to join this Japanese company. So there, straight away, I just got to join the accounts department. And while I was working, they identified my talents and they wanted me to go for higher studies of account. So I started doing SIMA. And I did two parts of SIMA. At that time only my parents brought this proposal and I had to get married. And
so
after that,
that she is.
But were you always very fashion forward?
Definitely.
Always.
My mother was like that, even my grandma. was okay, like
so
that.
So it runs in the DNA.
Yes.
Okay. Her grandmother, her mother has blue eyes.
What?
Had blue eyes, and also the grandmother was a Eurasian.
It skips generations.
Yes.
Yeah, I'm really hoping.
Yeah, my grandma was, I still can remember, she had this cashmere silk saris and she was to wear those with matching shoes, high heels and matching handbags, and then my mom was also like that.
So well, it's in the DNA, so you can't.
Yeah.
If you also have a girl, then you are done. It's going to continue.
Whole thing.
Yeah. So now, so that was your start. You got into work, and now you have also become a married lady.
Yes. So what happened was, after soon after I got married, after about 2 weeks, I had to start my work here. Mm. My husband was stationed at Randhinigala Rantabi Hydropower Project. He was an engineer there. So we didn't have any like possibility of working in one place. Mm. I was in Colombo and he was in Randhinigala. So we decided to just work like that, and once a month he comes to Colombo. So after 2 weeks, when I went to office, so I had to start work, and that time this like we had to call each other.
Yeah.
And this telephone.
Butterflies were all over.
And telephones were not there like these days.
Yeah.
Only this office phone was helped us. So what I did was early morning, I just used to go to the office.
Off peak hours, so it's fine.
And I started giving him calls. So he gave me calls in the morning. So one of our officers, he has noticed this and he has complained it to the boss.
There's always a villain in every love story. Yeah.
Yes. And then that time I had a very tough Japanese director. He issued me a letter saying half of the company telephone bill will be deducted from your salary. So what to do? I informed this to my husband. He decided to resign. And okay. I had to go and stay with him in Randhinigala.
That's where the project journey starts.
Yes.
An interesting story from there onwards, I have to speak about it. Shani, you have heard this story and you have seen it happen as well.
Yeah.
Tell me something that's in your mom that's very something that you always hold very close to you, like a quality in her.
Well, she is very detail oriented. Like she takes she goes to great measures and great lengths into doing something perfectly, and so no half jobs done,
and she notices a lot of things. Let's get into a break. We'll see you on the other side. You stick around. It's a date with them. So when you have two very serious ladies, you need somebody who can loosen the situation a little bit. By popular demand, we have Ihan.
Hi, I'm Ihan. I'm one of the founders of Crystal. I'm the best looking one out of the three, as you will notice. I'm the beauty of Crystal. Danu, what can I say? The only thing that reminds me of Danu is this. That's exactly what reminds me of Danu. This bugger was adamant to go on a date with me for longest time, so finally I agreed to come on this, so here I am.
Welcome back to the show. Now the family is complete. They're all on board. So, Ihan, thank you for being here.
It's a pleasure.
Oh, yeah.
As always.
We needed somebody to rock the boat a little bit. So, Ihan, you're also part of the whole Crystal family team. And you have no choice as
well. Yeah, no choice. As you can see, I'm the better looking out of the three.
Yeah. It all
makes sense. Of the family. Yeah.
The ambassador to the brand. Yeah.
Yeah, especially. Yeah.
The billboard is just outside.
Yeah, exactly,
the cutout is done. Yeah. So let's speak about this when you all got together, Auntie, what was your opinion?
Couldn't have done any better.
What was your first thought when you met Ihan?
You have to be nice, Mama.
She's like, let's think on this a little bit. She definitely loves you the most now, but now.
Of course. Yeah. And I just gave her the preference for her to like Jeez. These ideas.
Basically, Hati was the one who helped me like convince my mom.
For Ihan?
Yes.
Good choice. Yeah. Good
choice. Tati sold it. I think my dad was like uncle.
The two fathers have had the discussion. Mothers didn't have
to. But they were known to each other, no? So, before, yes. That's what we came to know later.
Okay, yes. Because okay. Plan, destiny made its way. All right. So now, Ihan, in today's world, something that I've noticed, you manage so many things. How in the world do you actually have the strength to do it? Because you're also attached to like a garment.
Yep.
And then you also, not garment, garment. And very the spontaneous, nice ones, which we wear underneath.
Yeah. All in the beauty, no? So that's why.
It works very well.
It works well.
But you were never into this. You wanted to be into IT.
Yes, I'm a software engineer. Otherwise, I would have been a chef, if not.
Right.
But I like the company, the culture is good. So underwear, it's all good, lingerie, so can't
go wrong.
Can't go wrong.
Mm-hmm. But the shift, was it hard for you to like go from code work, like coding, right? You call it?
Yeah, coding.
Coding to
sit and just keep on coding was not my thing, you know, meet people.
He's a people's person. Yeah, he's a massive people's person.
And he not many girls as well in IT, so that's also downer.
And IT is a very high risk of depression.
Yeah.
Good that you came out of it.
Yeah.
Now you're looking
Don't know what, but it's better, but still good I get out of it.
But it's good. It's good. Now you're coding other things.
Yes. Absolutely.
Yeah. All right. So now, Shani, in today's world of beauty, there's so much of stigma. Like, you know, I'm so happy there's the myth about being fair is broken. You have been someone who has always promoted nobody needs to be fair, you just need to be the best version of you. When you got into this industry, now Auntie has been, we have to come to a story later, if it was not into this cosmetology, would have you made your way here?
Well, in this industry,
in this field, because there's so many options in medicine, right?
Yeah, I mean, it was especially because of Ammi, because I saw her doing these things. Mm. I remember she had...
Did you want to be a doctor?
I wanted to become a pilot first.
Right. Height is an issue, no?
Forget that. So my
can't
mom
reach
and...
the paddle or anything.
Well, but my mom and dad like snapped me out of it.
Okay.
But it's all for the best, I guess.
You wanted it for the uniform, no? I know you.
Yes.
Yeah. So, Auntie, let's go back to your time when... So, I've heard this story, so I'm trying to like bring it out in different parts so it all makes sense. So, you loved dressing up and you loved to dress Shani up when she was a little baby. And you were bored. Now, you were far away from the city life.
City. And I didn't have... when I was working, I had... enough
funds.
After that, when I went there, I found it like for everything I had to depend on my husband. Mm. I loved to dress her and I knew how to do this nice frilly dresses and all. So my mom was a very good seamstress. So I now even I can whatever the design I see, I can just cut
stitch it out.
Yes. So for which to buy the materials, that was the problem. So I had to depend on uncle for everything. So anyway, I enjoyed her company, and then we were provided with nice, beautiful houses and then gardens.
Mm.
So I was happily doing all those, bringing her up. I just taught her all these small little nursery rhymes, and then I taught her all the manners. When
etiquette
she was
training,
everything.
All done.
At that time, I just took
the time to
maximum years of it, and I maintained a beautiful house and the garden as well. So it was the time for me to bring her down to Colombo.
For school?
Yes. Mm. So then uncle had 1 year more to complete there at Randanijala. So I just brought her down and put her to Holy Family Convent, nursery school. So I was bringing her to the school. And then until from 11:30 or 12 o'clock at that time, nursery school. So we were doing nothing. All the parents, all these moms were doing nothing. So I thought, why not I start something? Because
she's definitely not a lady of leisure.
Definitely not. You wanted to make yourself busy there.
Yeah. So when I was working in this Japanese company, I got opportunities to visit Japan 2-3 times. And then there I found 2-3 schools to go and study this floristry, vegetable carving and different handcrafts. So I thought, why not I do this for these ladies to make extra income for me.
True.
So I by myself went to, I still can remember, went to Lake House and just put an advertisement saying that I'm going to start classes. People didn't know much about me, but I got 3 girls for the classes at first. I was happy.
What is more interesting in achievement is when you don't expect it and it just happens. And she has a professor title that has been honored upon her by the state.
Yes.
Let's get into a break. There's more to this story. Now we're going to speak a little bit about the new ventures of Crystal when we do come back. Please stick around. It's a day to day. When you have people like Ihan, who is like a playboy capital, and when you have a beauty doctor who is trending socially, we need to make sure that we take that social media photo. Welcome back. It's a date with Danu in conversation with Shani Ramani. It's so hard to say. Anihan, thank you for being on the show. As you know, Crystal Skin Clinic has come in as title sponsors as well on the show to speak a little bit about how important it is to feel good and how important it is to not feel ashamed about the fact that you might need some help at times. Let's speak about this myth with Shani. You see so many people every day with different walks of life. They come with different types of problems, and sometimes problem could be one thing, but the emotional trauma that they've gone through because it is something else, and you have always put this up on social media. What's the most common thing that people come and talk to you about?
Well, I guess skin lightening, number one, acne, and then I guess like anti-aging.
Okay.
Yeah.
How soon should somebody work on anti-aging?
It depends from person to person. Like some people look older than their actual age. Sometimes after like giving birth and all, people look older sometimes.
This was just for me, just wanted to check.
30 plus?
I'm there already.
And you're doing stuff already,
hello? No, this is just natural.
Natural.
I don't even know where Christy is located. So how do you sort of, because I know a lot of people come and they're like, oh, this has to be confidential. So then how do you sort of deal with all of this? Because sometimes they might not even want to do treatments openly or like even walk in through the place to like speak to you.
Well, we have, for that, we have something known as the special hours.
Okay.
For if you're really, really uncomfortable, then you can come after hours.
Where it's not too crowded.
Yeah, we give that special opportunity where you can feel comfortable.
Yeah.
But obviously in the medical profession,
confidentiality
we are bound by it. But if you are uncomfortable, others seeing you walking in, we make that special effort.
Ihan, in this pool, how do you handle the two of them? As now you
he
take
has been
the...
very diplomatic because he's going home with us. Yeah.
Exactly.
Yeah. So how do you handle, because they're both very what can I say, driven women.
Yeah.
And they are both,
they're all visionaries.
Yes.
So I look after execution of it.
Right.
Yeah.
And also bring some really, you know, reality to the
valid points to the table.
Yeah.
Okay. Who shoots you down the most?
Ooh.
I will be there to hold your hand.
Yeah. No, the shooting continues when we sleep also, so the length, the depends on the length and the volume, but yeah.
Okay. I understand. Who is harder to convince? I feel like this is like a set of questions I need to ask.
So now I have tried different mechanisms of convincing, get other people to do the influencing rather than direct.
Okay.
Yeah, because sometimes direct approach
can backfire.
Yeah, backfire. Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. So others have also been victim to this. To your charm and to their Yeah, I'll keep that in mind. Just because I might need
it. Sachin does an amazing job managing the both of us because it's not easy. Like you said, we are extremely like focused, driven. So sometimes...
And you all are also emotionally driven.
Yes. And both of us are emotional.
Yes.
Like so.
My father is like a cucumber. Okay. Even the roof falls...
He'll just be there.
A replica of his father.
So that really helps. So it doesn't bother me, you know. Okay. Shoot down, get on with it.
That's amazing. That's really good. That's a quality that people should admire. Because I've actually seen it. He's like actually a sponge. He can just observe and just absorb everything and be like...
It goes straight here.
So now, Auntie, this journey from there, eventually you started studying professionally for this cosmetology. At that time, Sri Lanka didn't have anything like that.
No.
We put soap.
Yeah.
There were two to three pioneers in beauty, cosmetic beauty in Sri Lanka. So I just took the educating part.
Mm.
So then I thought I should equip myself and then brush up. That means go to the
depth of it and learn it.
So my husband, he helped me a lot to become who I am today, and then he selected all the good unis and the institutes in the world, and he sent me there to study about cosmetology.
She has gone to all the countries.
Yes,
mostly.
I completed my cosmetology like higher diploma in USA, and then only I brought this word cosmetology to Sri Lanka. And then I of course wanted at that time when I went to these schools and universities, I saw now we all in, as I told you, there were 2-3 pioneers in Sri Lanka. They all hired these halls, and when we went to teach them, we didn't have enough like facilities in those areas. So I wanted to give these Sri Lankan ladies gift them under one roof. Yes.
Yeah.
And international level education, that means place for beauty hairdressing.
Yeah.
So when I went to all those places, I saw those, and then I wanted to have a place in my own. So because
and
of
close
that,
close to Shani's school.
Yes.
Yeah.
God help me. Then I was looking for a small piece of land at that time, and then luckily I got this land. And then at that time, it was very expensive.
Yeah.
And I just asked uncle, "How about this?" Uncle said, "How can I do this? How can you do this?" And then I said, "We'll try and just do something." And went and met one of our friends. That time he was a bank manager at Bumblepity branch. And so luckily,
kept it in that area.
Yes.
Yeah.
And then I went and told him that I want to buy this piece of land, and he helped me, right, to buy this land. And to buy that land and do the structural part, uncle helped me, and then we did that. And to do the interior part, I didn't have much funds.
But you had all the knowledge.
Yes. What I did was, being in that building which I hired, I was there for 12 years, and then I was doing classes daily, day-to-day classes. I earned something and went to this novel area alone by my vehicle, picked each and every tile by me for the floors. So I was the first person to have an international That was
Academy
for Cosmetology.
It's amazing. So, and yes. it's all just a growth unexpectedly. And there's also a 5 rupee sari that I have to talk about when we do come back. Please stick around. So we have made some questions that they have to answer, and we call this segment Hot Seat. Welcome back to the show. I really am contemplating whether I should play the game with her. Yeah, I'll start with you.
I'll start with you.
Safe bet.
Yeah.
Safe bet.
Yours are easy, Ane.
Not easy.
Shani's worst quality. easy for me to ask, I wanted to say that.
Yeah. Sometimes does not sleep in the middle of the night when she gets ideas.
Okay.
And then wakes me up. Yeah, I have this idea, so now I like get a book, write it, tell me in the morning, so I don't have to.
But you never know, sometimes.
Either way, I need to sleep.
Yeah. Okay, fine.
This beauty doesn't come without sleep.
I didn't write these questions. That's nowadays. Fine. There's a reason why I didn't want to write it these days. Does being partially bald make you feel insecure, given that you are Shani's husband?
If I knew that we are going to start Crystal and do well, I would have shaved my head off before getting married, for sure. Otherwise, in office, there's only like, you better get hair before I come. So now I'm doing the treatment to make sure I get
because
it.
Because he's not bothered. Like, I mean, he is very happy the way he is.
You like that easy breezy.
I look good, so there's nothing to worry about. So.
Yeah. No. Yeah. You know, that's what you call confidence. Yeah. That's what we are promoting, so forget about it. Yeah, exactly. But this is also because you work for a place where they've recruited half of Sri Lanka.
Yeah.
Yeah, so we better start growing there. Yeah.
Exactly, so now we are doing it.
Yeah.
I can name a few people who are bald there as well.
They come to me and like, do you have hair treatment? Like, but you grow first before I come. I'm like, yes.
But you tell them that you can't be bothered.
I tell them, they come. They come now, yeah.
All right. Name a public figure that you feel who needs Botox badly.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God.
By the way, Iran works at MAS, just saying.
Public figure. Ranil Wickremasinghe?
Kids did laugh.
You can say something to the mouth, I guess. Like, Botox the mouth so they can talk.
Yeah. Oh, talks a lot.
But you can't Botox them to be quiet.
The person can paralyze any muscles. So.
Yeah. So then I had to go with Danu. I feel the person who talks the most in my life.
What?
That was that. He was playing safe there.
Yeah, I know. You have other people, no? Okay. Love or career for you?
Love. Oh. Have to go home also. these balls have to play back and back together.
Alright, Shani, to you now. If you don't like any of these questions, keep me informed quietly. Mm. If you had to change one thing about Ihan, what would it be?
Him being messy.
Understandable. Yeah, I have seen that happen. You know, actually, somebody told me getting a charger from you is the easiest. I'm the only one who returned your charger. Because if you take a charger from him, he never asks for it. He just goes and buys another charger.
Yes.
So I was like, that's a great thing to do. But I felt bad about it. Alternate career choice.
Pilot.
Yeah.
Listen, I also wanted to be like supermodel for Victoria's Secret.
Yeah. Okay? That I can help you out with.
Thanks. If they get into this. If I can get into that also, it'd be a great thing. Had you not been beauty doctor in Sri Lanka, who would you have consulted with? I have name options here, which I'll stay away from saying.
Go for the name options.
What? Really?
Yeah. No, I don't think so. Then everybody will feel...
Yeah. Because Shani is a doctor, no sin. We will not make her feel so bad. If not your beauty doctor, who would you go to? Say you are the pilot now.
Okay, right. I would go to my mom. Hmm. Because, No. Because when I started my career,
Believe me,
when you start, you make mistakes, right?
Yeah.
Like you learn from somewhere and you come and you apply the theory.
Yeah.
I burnt faces. Like
really?
That there were like laser burns, little mistakes. And then all of a sudden you had no one to turn to. They're like, what am I going to do? She always like such practical, she always saved. And she has that experience. So,
but how do you like come out of a situation like that?
Well, first, that's why experience matters. Like you do your mistakes and now you come to a place where you know what could go wrong.
You practice on us first, so at least the mistakes are those.
that's why they are the guinea pigs first. But it's about being very honest with your patients.
And telling them.
Telling them. Because if you try to cover something up, you know, that's not going to help anyone.
Yeah, true.
And when you're, and this is a journey, you know, like my clients are there with me before their marriage, like after their childbirth, anti-aging, it's like a journey. Yeah. So, being honest and then being realistic.
Yeah, you can remove the scar as well. So
yeah.
That's okay. Yeah. Problems are not problems anymore. If you could go back in time, name one thing that you would like to change.
To be honest, nothing.
There's one.
I'd like to convince my dad not to go for surgery. That. Everything else I've learned, I think I've become who I am because of what has molded me. I told you, right? I was like a princess, not much issues growing up, but the things that happened, the things that
life has thrown at you.
Yeah, and it's those are the things that's made me who I am. So,
And it's also quite interesting because to be a medical doctor in this country, it takes a lot out of you.
Yeah.
The process is tiring. We'll speak about that. Finally, kiss, kill, or marry. These are your options: Ranjan Ramanayake, Mervyn Silva, Maitri Pala Sirisena.
Well, kill Maitri Pala Sirisena.
Okay. You have now kiss and marry.
Kiss Mervyn, not kiss.
As in Ranjan is a safe option to kiss and
marry Mervyn.
Mala.
Sorry.
Done. Fair enough.
Okay then, Mrs. Silva.
Fair enough.
Moving on to Auntie now.
Oh, can't do.
Your preferred personality for their skill in hair and beauty: Ramani Fernando, Naina, Bernie Balasubramanian.
It's Ramani Fernando always.
If you can go back in time to your wedding day, who will you choose to dress you today? Harris, Michael, Ramsey.
Harris.
If you had to pick a ministry for Ihan to run, what would that ministry be?
Give some options. Women's
social?
Affairs.
What?
It's only on women's affairs.
Social?
Public service? Or what is that something?
Yes.
Yeah, I think you'll do very good.
Yeah.
You should actually contest in politics. Yeah.
And he's honest. Like he does that out of like proper generosity. And
Very good. Well done. You all fared much better than what I expected. Well done. Let's get into a break. We'll see you on the other side, because when we do come back, we are going to be doing Sticky City, I think. Right, now I have to speak a little bit about a few things on our segment called Sticky City. All right, welcome back. So we wanted to speak a little bit about this cosmetology industry. It's such a big place right now, and everyone is, it's one place, because we had beauty salons at one time, but right now it's going to the second step. People really want professional help. And you have seen the industry grow from where it was to today. How safe are all these places? Before we go, what are things that people should keep in mind? Because it's not like walking into a place. I'm not asking this as a point of view from people who run Crystal, but I'm just asking as somebody who is in the industry.
I would say experience. Because, let's say for example, you know, even for a surgeon, right? If you're doing a surgery for the first time, what would you feel?
I'm not going.
Exactly. Like if you, it's not enough like treating 100 patients. You'll be doing it for years because you've done your mistakes, you've learned your lessons, you know what, like the moment we see a person, you should know, okay, this will work for this person. So I would say more qualification really matters, yes, but along with it, experience and the most best products. Because even if your intentions are so great, you've learned from the best schools. If you're using a cheap machine, a cheap product, it's risky as well. So experience and quality of products, I would say.
Okay. When people come with all sorts of, you know, today, especially the competition is growing and everyone is trying to stand tall, have people come to you all with problems that they have faced and how do you all sort of rectify it? Isn't it a scary factor when you have to take something that's damaged and to correct?
Well, that's also part of the experience and skill, right?
Yes.
And what I always say is, I don't blame another doctor or another person, because mistakes can happen,
yes, always.
And I hate it when people come and that's a warning sign. If about another doctor, I would think to myself,
okay,
you're gonna do the same thing no matter how much I try.
Yeah.
So, but you just try and help.
Especially some are not happy, right? So you, even whatever you do,
yeah,
so then it's a warning sign. If
that is like, you need somebody to counsel them through.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And some are having a habit like getting one treatment done from one place, going to another place like that.
Yeah. Yes, it's a process. No, it's a journey.
You have
that
to come
have to
for,
be a part
you know,
of.
Yeah. 3 to 6 months to fix it. Otherwise,
it's not going to happen. But I must say, I'm actually a living testimony to what happened to me once. And I wrote to Sean in the middle of the night. I was like, I woke up like this. I did an ice polishing and a peel and a clean up all in one go. My face, half of it was not even there. To a point I couldn't go anywhere for 2 days. My face was so bad. I have visual proof of how I looked. It was worse than this. It was not a sight. Not even my mother will love me. It was one of those sights. But it's scary, no? That what you leave so much of trust in one person and you don't want it to be a risque thing, you know, eventually end up with it. Now, I have to speak about this because I think it's very, very important. One of the reasons why Auntie wouldn't make it last time is the fact that Uncle passed away just a few months before that. The strength that you all have as a family unit is absolutely beautiful. He's very much there in conversation every day, and that's what's beautiful. He's living, although he's not physically present. Having that union is a gift today. Like, a lot of people don't experience that joy of having that compatibility. What do you tell them?
Like, life is not a bed of roses, that I always tell these girls. But whatever we have to face, and we have to have a good understanding in between each other, and there is a responsibility as a mom, as a like wife. So you should know aware of all those things before getting married, like, and thinking of you yourself also, it matters. I still can remember when I was pregnant for her, I was sick. For 9 months I was very sick. And when I went to my doctor, doctor asked me, did you think when you came with the bouquet of roses, with high heels and right, you have to like face a situation
for
like
nine
this?
Months.
Yes. So not only that, even other like values of lives also, I try to teach them also, right, when time comes.
Yeah. Did you ever think when you wore that suit and walked down the aisle?
No comments. Better off saying no comments.
All because you have to drive back home.
Yeah.
And sleep.
Yeah.
That's also a huge part. Let's get into what's on your Facebook, because we did some digging. And we have some pictures that we want to share and also come to know some stories about. Yeah, Facebook. Let's start it off with a bang. Talk about flexibility. You know, it's the key, right, in anyone's life?
Absolutely.
It's the key to manage many things.
Ooh. He still does this.
Yeah. Really?
When you're from little age, you become boy, bigger boy, even bigger boy.
But this is flexibility.
Yeah, I know. Yeah. Can you imagine how flexible I am?
You
can.
Oh, go on.
Yo.
Wow.
What year was this, auntie?
This was in 1996, when I completed my cosmetology degree.
Same, know your look. Now, what's interesting is when I first saw her documentary, it was like all tall, fair people and white people. And then you can see auntie in the middle just like just maneuvering her way through and up to their chest. And you could just really spot her.
This is with Prince Philip. That is...
That's him? Yeah. That's a familiar face. I've seen him somewhere.
Queen Elizabeth's husband.
And who is at the back?
That is, I got a opportunity to represent Sri Lanka for Commonwealth Study Conference. That person was, represented Bangladesh.
Right. A major people. You have taken a few pictures with him. That's also him, right?
Yeah.
So I think he's the patron of the Commonwealth Study Conference.
Where is this? And what are you all doing?
During that conference, we had a group work. So from different countries, about 36 countries, there were about 200 delegates.
It looks like you all are having refreshments.
Yes.
No, they provided us with those.
I would have done that very clearly. Shani, was there ever a time that you wanted to merge into like film?
No.
No?
Mm-hmm. Well, That was when I was always Ami's model when she went for these like makeup classes.
Oh, right. How the pose?
I know, right?
Yeah.
Can't do that anymore.
I'm not doing that anymore.
For the first portfolio was that. All right.
When in Japan?
Yeah, only that.
Do you all have this outfit?
No.
No, we nicked it.
Why?
We nicked it from somewhere to the photo.
Ah, just for the photo.
What are we going to do that here?
You can bear it.
We took one, but this is not that.
Yes, another conference I represented Sri Lanka.
Again, this is the picture I said. It's only, like, you were the only person who was from Asia, is it?
Yes.
Yeah. It's quite interesting that you got a chance to, like, experience such great things. Now, here is the man who we spoke about. Now, he's also on the show.
My husband, yes.
Yeah. I do have a funny story as to how I met him first. Yeah, he and I had a fight as our first appearance. And I didn't know who he was, and I called Shani. He was like, somebody's calling me. And Shani's like, who? Oh, that's my dad. You still remember that phone call? Because when we were trying to sort out who this person was, the person was with me. He's like, do you think that's the dad?
Was it Navitra?
No, it was Sam. Like, do you think that's the dad? I was like, really? quiet now. Now, when you all got married, how many years ago was that?
Five and a half.
Who got intoxicated first?
On the wedding day?
Yeah.
Nobody.
I got drunk a little bit.
It shows.
Yeah.
She's like, This is one of those, like all the other pictures, you're so perfectly, like eyes open.
You know what, I'm so annoyed with him because he puts up the most stupid looking pictures up. This was on his Facebook, right?
Actually, Ihan has used his as his story.
I know.
What we don't want is what goes there. You are a big match boy, aren't you? Do you like switch off during a big match time?
Oh.
Unreachable.
Yes.
You're just worried about the picture right now.
Yes.
I'm just asking because Joe Pete is not so big, no? Although I'm a Pete, right?
Joe Pete is big compared to what?
Roy, though. But this is after you married Chani, right? Because you have blocked all the sun that you could ever get.
pity.
Ah, this is not sunblock.
No.
Really?
I thought this was eat the bun and then drink the coke or something, a lot of games.
Oh, right. I really thought this is because Shani said, like, please wear your sunblock. I see a blanket with like a full coat of it. Yeah, but it's interesting. Well, you know what's amazing is the fact that I think you all have a wonderful chemistry and that's what keeps it going, all three of you. So we are so happy as a show to have you to speak about how amazing walking into Crystal is, even especially as somebody who goes there. Wondering, this is not natural. Needed some professionals to work on it. But it's amazing with the fact that you feel like home and you don't feel like you're a stranger there trying to figure out answers, you know. If only like other places could be, because I have gone through hospitals and this is not a hospital. This just makes you feel like you're walking into a clinic of love, which is good. Thank you. Auntie, you have a remarkable story. Before we go, I just want to speak about the 5 rupee sari. So Auntie loved dressing up so much and she just didn't like the fact that she had to ask her husband always, can you, like, you know, because he used to like break his salary into all the responsibilities he had. She used to ask him for all the coins that he will get. Then the 5 rupee till became your, eventually a sari.
Sari, yes, I bought. Still I have that sari.
That's amazing. Yes. You should keep that. It's your special sari. But her want was something else. And what she built out of it was totally an unexpected monument, which is just magnificent because today it is feeding so many people, giving life to so many people and has become the bread and butter of so many. So well done, Auntie.
Thank you very much.
Thank you for being here. You all look fabulous. You're wearing a chari and you're wearing a Yolande.
Yes.
I'm just wearing me.
Right then. On that note, let's wrap things up. Thank you so much for joining us on Date with Danu. We'll see you soon. Till then, keep smiling.